Hey, Penny Fish. It's the 14th of March, 2018. And I'm sure most of you, wake up. This is what I try to do. I try to wake up every morning with the Lord in my heart and just ask for His Holy Spirit to keep me on the narrow path, you know? Just to steer me clear of the wickedness of this world, man. Because it's wicked, you know what I mean? Maybe be able to help somebody out or something, keep me out of trouble. And, so this morning, this is the first thing I see. I mean, I sit down to check on things, maybe read a little scripture. And this is Drudge again. And I just see this and I'm like, you got to be kidding me. It just, first of all, the horses and the photo finish, that's one thing. Okay, but a 641 vote difference, I see the 11 right off the bat, and then a double 13. And it just comes upon my spirit, like, this whatever is under that surface is really, really about to blow through into this world and come in the form of ugliness. And I mean, just ugliness. Things you do not want to experience, okay? But we don't live in a pretty world as it is. I mean, this place is really, really dark. It's so contaminated, It's like a giant cesspool, essentially. And we're just kind of like floating around on the cleanest stuff that we can find. But if you're in the Word of God, I'm telling you, if you don't know Jesus, then you don't know God. And if you don't understand how this world came to be, who you are, and what the deal is, man, and understand that you do die someday, your flesh dies. And it doesn't all end there, necessarily. How you live does matter, and how your heart is, essentially, truly matters. It just does. And so I'm seeing the 11, 13, 13. And then right here, of course, Stephen Hawking dead at 76. Another 13. So like, bam, 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 bam. And then yesterday, I didn't even think too much of it, but I saw this article and it was talking about this walkout that's happening all over the country today. Okay. This is actually the 11th. This is a couple days ago. But nonetheless, there it is in my browser. And this is all about the school shooting, of course. The 17 people. They're going to spend 17 minutes for each victim. And I'm looking at this, and all that's coming through my mind is the absolute sorrow that I feel for all these people who have quite literally just been so deceived, as I was deceived before I came to find the truth. And the truth will only be found in this book called the Holy Bible. And when you ask for the truth, and it's all about your heart, I mean, you need to humble yourself. And by that, I mean, for me, I had to go to the... Put it this way, I went in the elevator, went to the bottom floor, but I brought a shovel and a wheelbarrow with me so I could keep digging down and, bring the dirt up and keep... I had to pretty much die in order to live. But everybody else doesn't have to go through that, You can come to Christ, a lot easier. And that's my hope. These poor people, man, these kids, they're being led and programmed by godless freaks. I mean, that's just what they are. And driven by emotion. I mean, to actually believe that people like their guns over their children is pretty insane when you think about it. It's just absolute insanity. So, the world is literally like 2 seconds away from when I say turning on its ear, I mean, you got to just imagine, you know, as if it's not completely and utterly wicked enough as it is. And we're only just starting to see the true depths of the wickedness, you know, Pizzagate, Podesta, Clinton, and that's only the tip of the iceberg, people, okay? So there's calamity coming on this world, and it's coming very soon. And if you're not in Christ, I'm just telling you this, you are going to essentially have to endure horrific, terrifying things. And when that comes upon you, you need to call on the name of Jesus, because maybe, just maybe at that point, you'll be down deep enough into that pit in your belly to make that connection and really mean it. And then you're going to have to endure. And that's just how I see it, okay? I don't know God's exact plan, but I know he's working, and I know this stuff is on, and it is here. That's all I can tell you. It's all I'm being shown. We're at a photo finish here, people. This is like down to the line. Seek Jesus Christ humbly and sincerely and ask him for the truth. He will show you. Okay? This is no joke. Now I gotta go move massive, massive amounts of snow. Maybe I'll take some pictures and share them with you later. I don't know. But, yeah, seek his face today, all day, every day. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,